Hi everyone, welcome to the SAP Developer News. This is DJ and Nico, and we are here in front of Building 3 in Saint-Cloud for UI5Con and recap.
Yeah, this is the tech event of the year. Today, UI5Con, you can see people coming in, and tomorrow is recap, the CAP conference, and of course on Saturday we have an SAP Code Jam on CAP as well with me and Nico. So yeah, we're here, we're looking forward to it, and what's next?
Be on the lookout for recordings.
Hi. Hi SAP developers, it's great to see you all again. But for this week, I want to reach out to you mobile developers. Were you aware that the SAP Business Technology Platform SDK for iOS 9.2 became available just over a week ago? As organizations have come to trust SAP mobile services for their evolving security needs, with this latest release, the engineering team has brought some exciting new features for you to explore. Here are some of the security highlights. Device compliance, bring your own device enterprise data access on all trusted devices. Apple's app attestation improvements, which provides strong evidence about managed devices. Clipboard protection improvements that regulate data flow in your app by restricting cut, copy and paste. Enhancements to multi-user mode again amongst users sharing one device, new Swift UI kit-based controls in SAP Fiori, and accessibility enhancements such as voiceover support. Please visit the blog mentioned in the links below, as well as the documentation and API reference, to get a detailed overview of the features release. Whilst you're here, you know I love taking my podcast wherever I go, and I'm happy to share that we have an anniversary to celebrate. This Saturday, our podcast channel will be 1 year old. In fact, this week's SAP Developer News will be our 53rd news show and our 112th podcast. These 112 are also made up of 55 for Devtoberfest, 3 Code Talk, and 1 special one from Rich Harman. In total, we have had nearly 16,500 downloads of all episodes, so thank you for listening. And if you haven't subscribed, subscribe today. The link's also in the comments below.
The final week of the June Developer Challenge has come to a close, and those of you who participated will be getting your badges shortly. If you missed out on the June Challenge and you want to learn more about React and the SAP Web Components for React library, you can always go back to each week and try your hand at the challenges. The Code Sandbox project and each week's discussion post will be open and available for anyone to go back to. I will also be posting my solutions to each week's challenges into the sandbox very soon, so you can compare your solution to mine. If you want to join in on the fun, Nico is running the July Developer Challenge that covers how to get started with SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, or CAP. Over the weeks, you'll be building a CAP service that tracks rounds of golf, and week one will get you started with CAP and domain modeling. The link to the announcement post in the first weeks is linked in the description below. In exciting front-end news, the SAP Web Components for React just released version 1.17 and now supports server-side rendering frameworks such as Next.js. This is exciting because server-side rendering can be beneficial for faster load times, static websites, and more. In the description below, you'll find links to the announcement tweet, their server-side rendering docs, the project template page, and more to help you get started. Congratulations to those who completed the June Developer Challenge. Good luck to those starting the July Challenge, and as always, happy coding.
Hey everyone, Josh Bentley, and I'm still working here in the beautiful SAP Labs office in Bengaluru, India. I wanted to let the developers here and our audience worldwide know about a great webinar coming out from the Open Source Program Office. The OCM is the Open Component Model. So what exactly is it and why should we care about it? The OCM provides a standard for describing delivery artifacts that can be accessed from many types of component repositories. There are specifications, a Go library, examples, code contributions, and even something for our friend and colleague DJ Adams. Yep, you guessed it. There's a command line interface. And now that I said it out loud, DJ's probably going to be up all night. Anyway, My favorite part is an artifact, because an artifact is a blob containing some data in some technical format. I also live in Phoenixville, and Phoenixville is a famous city in Pennsylvania because a movie from 1958 was filmed there called The Blob. Anyway, I just like saying the word blob. Flob. But there's also another great reason to attend this webinar by Ingo Kober and Jason Kafka. These two speakers will not only share all about the OCM, but they'll also talk about their experience on how the team navigated through a development culture clash for effective collaboration. And as I am here in one of the largest development sites in all of SAP, I can't think of a better place to promote this webinar. So please, click the links below to read all about the OCM project and register for the webinar, which takes place on July 19th at 1300 UTC.